see a very very a great set of skills standing up on the floor, and he's also a champion. So it means he's not gonna mentally. It's gonna be fun.
How have you been conditioning yourself? To anything different this fight than others, or from what you've seen?
I do stuff differently now, new pattern, new drills, and a little bit different stuff. It's going to be fun fun to experiment that in the fight.
You're the champion, but do you think you have anything to prove at all other than just beat this guy?
No, I think he's a lot of guys, a lot of people in the sport consider him the best guy at 170. So for me, it's important. I want to be the best guy, so I need to fight him to figure who is the best guy.
I imagine that wouldn't sit very well with you, right? The people who consider him the best guy.
Yeah, but you know what? There is only one way to find out. I can say whatever I want. You can say whatever you want. At the end of the day, okay, we'll find out the answer October 29 at night when the fight is over.
George, you seem to fight better when you're facing a pressure fighter. Nick Diaz is clearly one of those guys. What do you need to do to make sure that you beat him to the punch, so to speak?
I think I got a better variety of weapon to beat him, and I'm going to use it all and take advantage of that.
Have you worked on anything in particular with your training, like concentrating on any sort of part of your training?
Oh yeah, a lot of different things that Nick Diaz does. I've been working a lot of specific stuff that is exceptionally for Nick Diaz.
His style.
Yes.